Now, here's Chris.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the exciting new sound of Radio X. Pippa's back from her Workiversary on Friday.
Yeah.
Hello. I had a headache all day.
She had a day off. Day off, paid day off to celebrate her the anniversary of her joining this company. So she decided to take it Friday because went into your Workiversary, which is a word that I believe Global invented. They go, you can have a day off from us to say thank you for joining our company, but you got to take it within the next week. So she's like, all right, I'll have Friday off then. And of course, this is brilliant because the world is Pippa's oyster. She can do whatever she wants. Yeah. She's got Friday off. She can go out there. Obviously, she's got to be careful going out with Toby because he's got work really early on Friday morning because he doesn't get the day off. And she also gets up at like, what time do you get up?
Half four.
Yeah. Every day of the week. Half four. Monday morning, Tuesday morning, Wednesday morning, Thursday morning. So Friday, she's not going to wake up early because she's got a day off. So she's going to lie in till 11 and be fed grapes by hunky men and do whatever she wants.
Oh, lovely.
What time did you wake up Friday morning?
Well, I woke up early, obviously, but then I made myself go back to bed again.
Lovely.
So I eventually woke up at 8:30.
And what did you do?
Honestly, this is so sad. I had a headache all day. I had a clamp headache and I felt like I had to take 8 paracetamol, not on one go, but over the course of the day.
Oh, 8?
Yeah.
Wow. Look at you.
God.
Ill popper.
So ill. And I had visions of doing all this creative stuff.
Bite that microphone. Go on.
And I was going to go down to the cricket nets to practice some bowling, guys, because I had to bowl at the weekend. And I didn't do any of it. So, pretty boring, really. Nice, though. Like, relaxed.
So your day off wasn't great?
It wasn't, sadly.
Should have come to work.
Yeah.
You should have said to them, I'm not going to take a day off, but what I'm going to do is, can I split that day into hours? So I'm just going to have... So I'm going to leave work an hour early or come in an hour later over the next few weeks.
Oh, lovely.
That would be nice.
So the show starts at 6:30. Pippa rocks up about 7:15.
Yeah.
Hi, morning, guys.
Oh.
A lovely lion.
I could do that for like 7 weeks.
Yeah.
Great.
Imagine.
Wonderful.
Yeah, we don't get a workiversary, Dominic.
We don't get a workiversary.
Stupid rules.
Workiversary.
Yeah, you don't, do you?
No, we don't.
I mean, congratulations, guys, because it'd be around about now, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
And also, as well, I brought you in.
You did.
To this family.
Yeah.
And I get nothing for that.
No.
I don't even get a kickback. I don't even get... you should get a day. I should at least get an hour.
Yeah, you should get some commission on the deal.
So, like, Monday morning, I can finish at 9. Some would argue that I could technically do.
Well.
But, and then I get to go, it's 9 o'clock, bye. And I leave. Yeah.
Do you want to leave at 9?
Yeah.
We could arrange that on Monday.
Yeah. Do you want to do it today?
Yeah.
What was that? No, was that a yes or a no? It sounded like a both.
You.
It's a management. Yeah, no, I don't.
Yeah. Oh, yes, no.
We haven't had a Dom's Disco for a while, to be fair.
We haven't had a Dom's Disco for a while.
With you.
It's not a bad thing. We haven't had one for a while, probably.
DJ Dom in the house.
Yeah.
Dom's Disco.
Biggity Bong. That's what cool DJs say, isn't it?
Yeah.
Biggity Bong. What?
Can I have that hour now?
Let's have it in the middle of the show.
We're on live on Global Player if you want to watch, by the way. Good morning, everybody, if you are watching. If you're watching live on Global Player, great. It's very easy. You open up Global... Will you stop hitting the microphone?
So
what's it done
sorry.
To you?
I've got, like, my fingers have grown.
It's your witch fingers.
Yeah.
Very long fingers.
Too long.
I have long piano-playing fingers.
You can watch us on Global Player Live. You can watch us on your phone through the app. You can watch us on the telly through your app. You can do whatever. Or if you're watching the replay on YouTube, you should be watching live. And I'm not allowed to plug the YouTube replay because Ashley hasn't bought YouTube yet.
Yet.
All right. Morning, Ashley. Yeah, I'm going to buy YouTube.
Wouldn't that be cool? How much is YouTube to buy?
I don't know, but that
quite
would...
a lot.
Our if we had Christmas parties anymore, those would stop.
They'd stop. The ones that have stopped would stop.
We need to remind Global that COVID's over, you know, that lockdown thing, because the last Christmas party, works party we had was 2019, and then...
Was it?
The lockdown came, and so we didn't have one in 2020.
Yeah, true.
And we didn't have one in 2021, or 2022. or 2023, and there's no plans to have one this year. It's like they've gone, oh, yeah, yeah, it's COVID, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's
like, well, people here now.
What?
There's too many people here.
Yeah.
We get a nice gift instead, though, don't we?
We do. It's very generous.
Do we? Yeah. What do we get?
Yeah, get a voucher.
Don't we?
So that's nice. That's nice, that.
It's lovely.
It's nice, that.
It's a lovely voucher. Mm. I guess that's what they'd spend
on everyone per head for the party.
Right.
Yeah.
Rubbish. Not with what I drink.
It's £1 million voucher.
I went for lunch with one of the bosses. James is the head of radio for Global. He's a lovely fella. Mm. Read the news on our show back in the day. Anyway, apparently.
I did.
I don't remember.
I gave him voice training back in the day.
Did you?
I did, yeah.
Did you?
Yeah. I came clear with the headline.
And now his voice is beautiful.
He's got a lovely voice.
He does.
Calming.
Very calming.
What a bunch of brown noses we are. Anyway, he goes, oh, before James. I forget, he goes, this is for you. I go, what is it? He goes, it's like a little thank you for the thing company. And I didn't realise everybody was getting one. And I went, oh. Okay, thanks. It's a voucher, get yourself something. A voucher? How much is it? It's that, a couple of £100 or something.
Yeah.
Really? Oh, great. He goes, no, but it's good, though, isn't it? It's good. And I went, it's good? No, it's not good. No. It's all right. Cheers. But that's it. It's not, you know. He goes, well, no, but that's really, it's a really nice thing because you got the voucher. I went, Chase, it's not a really nice thing, though, is it? But let's not go get into it. He goes, why is it not a really nice thing? Oh, do you want to have this conversation before? Okay, we'll have this conversation. Because of me and the Chris Moyles Show, we make millions of pounds for Global. Millions, plural. Millions of pounds for Global. Millions. What's in that envelope? A voucher for £200? What am I going to buy? And where's it a voucher for?
But they can't start giving people different amounts of money.
Yes, they can. Yes, they can, because the different people in the building make different amount of money.
Then you'd be like, how much did you get? And then everyone, oh, I got £50. Oh, you got to go, I got £50.
Yeah.
You got £400.
Yeah, 100%. What, you think everyone gets paid the same in the building?
That would be worse.
You think everyone gets paid the same?
No, but in terms
of... So what's the difference?
A bonus gift for Christmas, it would have to be the same.
So otherwise. Do you think that Nick Ferrari and LBC, who's got the flagship show on LBC, should get the same bonus as Danny Wallace, who does 1 3-hour show a week
as
on Radio
a Christmas
X.
Bonus, yes, but
you're
not
out of your mind.
Yes.
You're out of your mind!
Why don't they just give us money, like, depending on how much they like us? I think that's fairer.
What about the number one salesperson in the building who sells more airtime and adverts and brings more money in than everyone else? You think their bonus should be exactly the same as Ed Gamble's?
Christmas gift.
Gift.
Same, everyone. Otherwise, you're causing chaos and everyone. It'll have the opposite effect.
It didn't happen at the old place when we all got a bonus, but I got more than other people.
Oh, yeah.
Did you spoke about that on Friday?
I kept my gob shut, but it was years ago.
We found out the other day.
What was that?
We got a bonus at the old place once.
In the first like 4 or 5 months, wasn't it?
No, I think it was the end of the first year.
Oh, was it?
And we had revolutionised radio, to be fair.
Right.
The figures have gone through the roof.
Is this a breakfast or drive?
Breakfast.
Or breakfast. Ah, okay.
And we all got a little thank you very much for your hard work this year for going above and beyond.
Yeah.
And everybody got the same.
That's nice.
So they thought, but it's okay, I was the star of the show.
Yeah.
I think that's where the bonus is, isn't it?
And then, now, you from that place to this place, we don't even get a workiversary.
Workiversary. It sounds lovely.
Yeah.
But you only have 7 days to take it.
Yeah, yes.
Yeah, we've got one, but it's Sunday. Don't bother coming in.
And
we've
had one. Day to take it.
Don't have the day off, guys.
We go in every week.
Yes, Sunday's off.
Sunday's off.
Oh, man. I was DJing on Saturday night. I did this gig. And
how'd it go?
Yeah, that's right. And then on Sunday, so we drove back. It was fine. And then on Sunday, drove back and we borrowed a Range Rover.
Ooh!
From my mate John, who works for Lookers.
Ooh!
John.
Do you know, have I said this on the air before? So John, John works for this company. And he would lend us vehicles for when we were doing gigs and everything. Because I used to have to put my decks in the back of the car. And the boot of my car wasn't big enough for my decks to go in.
Your boot is very
big. So I can lend you a car. So he's lent us the Maseratis. You might have seen me videos and stuff. And, you know,
very nice. Yeah.
Great. And then he moved then and he went to work for a new company. And he goes, I can't give you a Maserati anymore. I'm at the new place. Can I give you a Range Rover? Is that all right? And I'm like,
oh, John?
It's like being asked when he's checking in for a flight going, I'm really sorry. Do you mind if we upgrade you to first class? Well, if it helps you, go on then.
Yeah.
And but he works for this company called Lookers.
Lookers?
Yeah. And Lookers is a chain of, a string of, they sell cars. And they've got showrooms all over the UK, right? But when I was a kid and I first started getting into radio, there was a Lookers, there was Lookers up north, and I thought it was just a northern thing.
Right.
And Lookers had the rights, whatever you call it, to sell Austin Rover cars.
Austin Rovers, wow.
And they had a jingle which said, look, look, look into Lookers for Austin Rover.
Ah.
Right. So John's got this amazing job at Lookers now, and they do Range Rovers. They do a range of cars, but they do Range Rovers and whatnot. But in my head, every time I hear Lookers, I just think Austin Rover cars.
Austin Rover.
That were British made, I believe.
Yeah, they were. Austin Rover. They were everywhere back in the day, Austin
Rover. They also sponsored the Mystery Voice competition on Pennant Radio, but that's really getting very niche.
Did they?
Yeah, they called it the Lookers of Bradford. Mystery Voice. Anyway. So we've got this Range Rover, and and then Gavin's with me for the gigs this weekend, and his job is tour manager. Hmm. It's a curious title.
Right, he's your TM.
So we get in the car, he turns up at mine, I've packed my DJ bag with all the stuff that I need, all the wires and everything, the headphones, the microphone, the laptop and all that. And then we put it in the car, and then I drive.
Right.
Whilst he sits there with his feet up on the dashboard, looking at his phone and chatting.
Because it's usually the exact opposite way around when...
Then he sits there and he goes, I really need a wee. And we're about half an hour out of, we're heading to Solihull. And I'm like, and he's like, and he's jigging about a bit, need a wee. And I just go, do you want me to stop over at the next services? There's services a mile away. I can probably hold it. But he says it like that. And I go, why don't I just stop at the service? You can have a wee. No, it's fine. So we stop. Off he goes. And then he comes back. You're all right now? Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then I drive again.
Right.
Drive to the hotel, check in and everything. And then it was one of those weird gigs where we had to do the sound check really early because it's like an awards ceremony. Okay. So we got to do the sound check at 6:30. It was Ireland, England at 5:00.
Yes.
So I made sure I was in. We got in, checked in, and I was in the hotel room at 5:01. Mm. Put the telly on. Great. I could watch the football. I wasn't on stage till 10:30.
Oh, wow.
So Gavin goes to sound check, comes back, and he goes, yeah, it's all fine. Here's how the thing works, and blah, 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 in the dressing room, and the walk to the stage, and all that stuff. He does all that recce. And then he goes, right, see you in a bit then. So off he goes. And then I'm like, okay, fine. So we ordered some food and had a pizza or whatever. And I'm like in this hotel room for hours before I go and DJ. Then we do the set and it's all fine.
Yeah.
And then the next day, I'm like, he can drive back. So he drives back.
Oh, good. I was going to say, can he drive? I'm sure he can, yeah.
Now we get home and Tiff's there, and then Tiff has to go out because she's got a gig yesterday. Boy George and Culture Club are playing the Boogie Town Festival.
Oh, yes.
You love that word.
Yeah, what a great name for a festival.
In Walton-on-Thames. So anyway, Gav comes back to ours, quick cup of tea, blah, 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 blah. Get him a taxi. He then goes. Lovely. Anyway, Tiff gets showered and changed. She goes, right, I've got to go now. And she's going to take the Range Rover because she's got to bring people to the gig. So she's, because there's so many of them, she's going to bring, like, because she can get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever.
Yeah.
In there. So she goes, you got the keys?
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, I think Gavin still has the keys.
Oh, no.
Oh.
And the rest of that story continues just after this short break. The time is 6:45. You're listening to Radio X. You just heard the pips there to signify it's 6:45, and I'm telling you it's Radio X. Write down the name of the station just in case somebody asks you, what do you listen to in the morning? You can tell them, I listen to The Chris Moyles Show on Radio X. Shower. Now, normally, at this time of the day, I talk all the way up to the vocal on a song. But this is quite a tricky one because it's a very, very long intro. But I'll try my best. Monday morning, back to it. Now let's get the music on, shall we? All the way back to 1988. Remember this one from Yellow? And it's called The Race. Gavin's got the keys, and Gavin is now gone.
How far has he been in the taxi now? How long?
His journey was 40 minutes to wherever he was going.
Right.
This is now about 42 minutes later.
Great. Excellent.
So I call him, and he goes, "Yep." And I go, "You got the keys to the Range Rover?" Oh.
Oh no.
Oh
yes.
No.
Yes, I do. I'll come back now. I said, "It's fine." And then, like Tiff. She took it very well.
Good. That's good.
I've got to bring five people to this gig. I told you specifically I needed that car. And I'm like, yeah, it's fine. Don't worry. It's not fine.
My tour manager is on it.
So.
Oh, dear.
So I'm like, he's going to come back with the keys. I'll get in the car. I'll drive to you. But I'm going to be late. I can't wait. No, you go. You go.
Yeah.
And then in the other car, which doesn't fit five people, doesn't fit four people. I mean, it fits like you'd fit Warwick Davis in there, but that's about it. So he got James Robinson.
Oh, I'll come around.
So she goes, and then I wait for Gavin, and then Gavin turns up, and I literally take the keys and goes, "I'm really sorry." And I'm like, "Fine." Now he'll stress about this because I know what it's like. He's stressy, right. So he's going to stress. So I'm then sending him text messages, going voice automated, going, "Don't stress now. It's fine." So Tiff's gone to wherever she's got to. She gets there. I get the keys from Gav, and then I jump in the car and I drive to the same place as she's driven. Now to get to where I'm going, I have to go literally. The road that I've just driven back from Solihull on.
Right.
And so, anyway, I get there, and it's all fine. And she's like, "Oh, sorry, I'm stressing." I was like, "It's fine. It's all done.
Yeah.
There you go. Now you've got the car. It's all lovely.
It's nice.
Go and say hello to George and Sadie, a few people." And then I go, "Bye." And then I get in the other car, and then I drive all the way home.
Right.
And that's when I decided I'm going to the bloody pub.
Yeah.
So last night...
Good for you.
I went to the pub at 20 past seven on a Sunday night before school.
Lovely.
And I had a bottle of Prosecco and I had a lovely time and we were politely asked to leave because it was 11 o'clock and we were the only people there.
Right.
And the guy went, "Can you go now, please? I want to lock up and go home."
That was last night?
Yeah, last night.
You're bright as a button today.
Yeah. Got to bed at midnight. Waited for Tiff to come back from the gig. Got to bed at midnight, up at five. So I'm shattered. I'm dead inside.
You don't sound it.
Yes. This is
dead
AI.
Inside.
This is not even me.
You've got a superpower, though, haven't you, with stuff?
Well, you
like
never
that.
Get a hangover. Ever.
Hangover?
No, I can be a bit fuzzy.
A bit furry. Fuzzy, though.
But
never hungover, really.
But no, I was in the pub on a Sunday. I can't remember the last time I went to pub on a Sunday night.
Mm. Oh, it sounds great when you say it like that.
Lovely.
Had a lovely time.
Yeah.
I was with Drunk Alan.
Oh, yeah.
And his missus.
Yeah.
Listening to their trying to get tickets to Oasis.
Story.
Yeah. Drunk Alan may have already received an email for the new Oasis dates.
Oh, has he?
Yeah.
Oh.
"Hi. I believe you tried to get tickets. So here's a code."
Oh, that's good.
And he sent me a copy of the email.
Yeah.
Without the code.
Yeah.
Because...
I had that email.
Did you?
Yeah.
What, the other day?
Yeah.
Did it say things on there that may or may not be true?
It just says you've got an invite to register. Register. I was going to say registrat. No.
Oh, I'm sorry. That was a registrat.
Registrat.
Sorry.
That's when your tummy gurgles and you fart at the same time.
That's what it's known as.
Registrat. You have an invitation to register for the private ballot.
Yeah.
So you do that and then. Then you get another one later saying, "Please confirm your ballot entry."
Yeah.
And then you just have to confirm your entry by midnight last night.
Yeah.
And then hopefully after that...
Yeah, you get a code.
Hopefully.
And then hopefully after that, that code helps you get tickets.
Yeah.
But none of this is guaranteed.
No. Oh, no.
It's the weirdest thing.
Because millions of people have got this as well.
Now, what does the original... thing, did you have to answer a question?
Yes.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was an Oasis question.
They're doing a quiz now, are they?
Please answer the following question correctly to help us keep bots out of the ballot.
Oh, yes. I see.
Was it about when did a certain band play a certain place?
Yes.
Right, okay.
The last time, yeah.
Okay.
I Googled it, obviously. Part of me wondering if they've got some sort of techie system where they can see if you've Googled it. Then you're out. Yeah.
Now, why did it say on the original email why you received that? Why you?
Yes, because you were one of the people who... Oh, not in this one.
Oh, OK.
But it did... Oh, hang on. No.
Did it say you have been identified as someone who... ..?
Yes.
And the ..?
Oh, yeah, no, it does.
And was that legit?
Yes. Okay. So you're in... Yeah, you've been identified as someone... It was basically anyone who was in the queue.
Right.
And did and wasn't successful. So that means Captain should have got one as well, right?
Well, true, do you want to go there, Captain?
Morning.
Did you get your email?
No.
What? You didn't
get
it?
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
He's determined to not see Oasis.
No, have you checked your junk folder?
I've checked the junk. I've checked it all.
But you were in the queue.
Oh, I know.
Don't forget his words on the on that group message that we're all in, where he goes, I'm even trying for Scotland now.
Yeah.
I'm desperate.
Even morning, Scotland. Even Scotland.
Oh, that is... Oh, I'm so sorry, Captain. I know I don't look sorry.
I'm chuffed for you.
Sound it.
I am.
It's killing yourself laughing.
When did the tickets go on sale for this these shenanigans?
That's right.
That's right.
So,
yes,
you've got to confirm by last night. Oh, and then you'll receive your code no later than 9 o'clock this Friday.
Now, that's 9 p.m. this Friday night.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, do you think that time might change like it did before?
Oh, definitely.
You'll get a code by 9 p.m., so maybe the tickets go on sale on Saturday. I don't know.
If you haven't received an email by then you haven't been selected to receive
Who's checking emails Friday night at 9 o'clock?
The entire thing is very complicated, though, isn't it?
It's so complicated.
Well, here's the thing.
Get an email.
So originally you had to, because we got really confused. For the Oasis tickets, you had to, if you wanted to be getting early, you had to register for the ballot, which means you had to say, hi, I want to be in the ballot.
Mm.
And then they would come back with their arms folded going, oh, you want to be in the ballot, do you? Well, answer these questions and tick this box for marketing. Yeah. I don't want to tick the box for marketing. Well, then you can't go any further.
What's the capital of Croatia?
Yeah. Yeah. So then you go, okay, fine. And then, so, all right, I've done all that. Now what?
Mm.
Now you wait. For what?
Just
you wait for us to get back to you. What is it? What, getting back to us with what? We will get back to you to tell you if you're in the ballot or not. But I've just registered for the ballot. But you're not in the ballot. But I want to be in the ballot. That's why I jumped through all them hoops.
It's that.
You'll be in the ballot when I say you're in the ballot.
When is
when will that be? That will be when I decide.
Exactly.
So Captain and I are checking our emails. Now we're in, waiting to be allowed in by the genie of the tickets.
Yeah. It reminds me of that bouncer at the club in Berlin who basically decides there and then whether you're allowed in or not.
Sven.
Sven,
yeah,
is it?
Yeah.
I get an email. I'm in the middle of a story. Shut up, James. I get an email.
You got an email.
Oh, yes, you can be in the ballot. Oh, great. But are you sure you want to be in the ballot? You need to confirm that you want to be in the ballot. I want to be in the ballot!
Why wouldn't you want to be in the ballot?
So I confirm I want to be in the ballot. And then it goes, right. Well.
Oh, you do you?
You might get a code. What do you mean I might get a code? Well, you're in the ballot now to try and get a code. Once you get the code, by the way, that doesn't guarantee you tickets.
Mm.
Then you use the code to try and get tickets. But there might be more codes than tickets available. So, best of luck. Bye-bye.
It's dark arts, isn't
it? I didn't even get a confirmation email that I'd registered in the first place. I didn't get anything.
Oh.
Why would you not even get that?
Yeah.
I know somebody who got an email on the latest round saying, because of your account at Ticketmaster, and we saw that you tried to get tickets, he goes, I don't have an account at Ticketmaster. I didn't use Ticketmaster to try and get tickets in the first place, but I'm in. Well, as in as can be. So anyway...
Good luck, everyone.
Good luck to everyone, and of course, Captain Crapbeard.
Yeah.
The £25,000 box. Radio X.
I feel like I've been saying this now for a week, but is today the day that it's going to go? I thought it was going to go on Thursday, and then I thought, right, it's definitely going to go Friday. It didn't go Friday, and then we got the extra clue on Friday. We got an extra clue on Friday, Pippa, on your day off, on your workiversary.
Right. What was that?
That the artist to unlock the box, the band, was formed in Wales.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
That was the extra one. That's what we got.
So
it's getting exciting.
It's narrowing it down. My brain won't allow me to try and work it out. So certain artists have popped into my head, but right. Like I've not sat down and gone right. Let me from the clues work out what this shortlist would be. But I know it's got to be a shortlist, which means it's really possible that the box is going to go today. This could be your last chance to text in to try and win £25,000. There's a really, really genuine now, really good chance it's going to go today because I thought it was going to go on Thursday and Friday.
Yeah.
There is a qualifying question if you want to get through, okay? So, 25 years ago, the 3210 phone was released. But who was the company that manufactured it? It's called the 3210. By... yes, them. That's the answer we're looking for. You need to text the word box and then write your answer and send it to 83936. If you want to enter the game, you need to text the word box and then your answer and send it to 83936. The answer to the question, not who you think the artist is. The 3210 phone was released in 25 years ago, but who was the company that manufactured it? Write the word box, write the name of the company that manufactured that phone and send it to 83936. Text costs £2 plus your standard network rate, but if you get picked to play today, you win £1,000 automatically. And then if you get it right, we'll give you another £24,000. Lines close at 8 this morning. If you text after that, you won't be entered, but you may still be charged. You need to be 18 or over and live in Great Britain to play. All the rules, including online entry at radiox.co.uk. This could be your last chance. It could go today. So seriously, text now.
The £25,000 box. Radio X.
And we... we'll be right back.
The Chris Moyles Show.